The fight direction for 12th Night, the challenges and kind of the exciting fun about, you know, the situation that we're in, the circumstances that we have on Zoom versus what would be a real life or in-person fight direction, rehearsal or choreography, performance or rehearsal. The challenges inherent are, of course, that, you know, the actors aren't in the same space physically, right? We're not in actual physical proximity. There's not a real kind of physical give and take or exchange of energy, right? We still have to build up the circumstances. We still have to imply that there's danger or effort or action happening, even though each actor is kind of by themselves in their own Zoom land, right? So the fun of that is to figure out how to give the value of what's going on between the two characters or more, the kind of value of danger, value of scariness, value of the kind of give and take that we would substitute for in, you know, in our real rehearsal situation. So then we get to figure out what tools do we have at our disposal that the actors can bring that they have. And I mean, not physical tools, but, you know, the intellectual, emotional tools that they can kind of give themselves and use to set up the situation, right? So in essence of a, like in substitution of a sword fight, or in 12th Night's case, not swords, but other props, the actors will bring them out. And then it becomes more of the attitude and the idea of there's a threat present, right? It's almost going to be kind of come through the camera to get to the other actor or the other character. And the implied threat is greater than the situation that's happening. So then the actors get to fill the moments with suspicion or anger or scared or any kind of reactions that you would have once an object gets put into motion or put into play. So then the actors have an exchange of, well, what's happening? What is that character doing? And what is my character doing in response to that? And then it becomes a lot of inference of, you know, what is being exchanged? What's in danger? What could almost happen outside of the realm of Zoom? And then the actors can really play with one another to give them whatever we need to kind of fill the scene. Because, of course, it's not physical. It's not real, quote unquote, right? It's not like in a regular rehearsal room. So we get to spread this action. Then it's more the idea of, well, I could do this. Or we have to keep the tension, right? And then the characters kind of continue off that. And then once other characters kind of enter into the scene, then all of a sudden the values change. Who gets to be scared for which character? Or who gets to follow the story of who's being attacking or who's defending or who's kind of instigating the fight? And then all of the actors via Zoom get to react just like they would be either watching almost like a gunfight, right? Like a duel between two gunfighters at the OK Corral or something, where the tension really begins to build. And then at some point, it gets almost to the point where there's physical action, and then another character comes in and changes the scene altogether. You know, their character is of a different status that brings in different energy that both characters have to respond to. And then the story continues to build. So unlike a fight choreography or a fight scene or fight rehearsal in a rehearsal room when the actors are present, this one is a lot more intellectual, emotional, and implied of action, that we almost get to that point where the actors can reach out and touch one another, when in actuality, it's all kind of built up in what the audience can see in the kind of new and different atmosphere that Zoom presents. So that's been like the most fun challenge of giving the value of what's going on between the two characters rather than giving the choreography. And there's still moves that they can do. There's still places and marks that they can hit. But then we have to figure out, well, what's the Zoomscape and sphere to make sure we're staying on camera while still showing this prop, while still maintaining the integrity of the scene. And that's been kind of the funnest challenge to overcome. And then everyone, you know, we kind of learn the vocabulary that we are all kind of playing with. We understand the situation and the arc between the characters and the intersection of those two points. And then all of a sudden we have a filled scene where everyone gets to observe, when in actuality, all of us are in different locations, but we're still kind of trying to go for the same story. So that's kind of been the process of how to build it. And then, of course, in the rehearsal room, Zoom room, we get together and we talk about what's going on. At what point, at what line, at what situation or what movement do things actually come into play? Like, is a prop coming out and then it's showed to the audience? Or is a prop coming out, showed to the audience, and then the other actor is reacting? Right? Are there other characters in danger for their life or curious about what's going on? Right? We build that vocabulary together, and then we decide on the choreography of each individual person reacting off one another. So it's still a story being shared. Right? And then from there, actors get more comfortable, and it's another part of the story, just like learning lines, dialogue, action, choreography, or kind of any other part of the conversation between two characters. So that's been kind of the process via Zoom.